Dear learners, I am going to deal with one of the topics in microbial biotechnology, that is fermentation and production of ethanol. Let me introduce myself to you. I am Dr. Jyoti S. Uppar, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Botany and PG Studies in Government Science College Autonomous, Ruputunga Road, Bangalore. So in this video, I am going to deal with two topics. First is fermentation and second is industrial production of ethanol. The first topic, let us look into what is meant by fermentation and what are its types. Well, the term fermentation, it is derived from a Latin word fervor, which means to boil. Fermentation is an enzyme catalyzed metabolic process, and here the microorganisms, they convert the starch or sugar to acids, gases or alcohol, and in the process it also releases energy. Fermentation occurs in yeast and also in bacteria. It also occurs in oxygen-starved muscle cells, for example, lactic acid fermentation. Fermentation, apart from being a biological process, it is also a chemical process. So let us look into the types of fermentations. The first type is aerobic fermentation. So here the process of fermentation takes place in the presence of oxygen. Second, anaerobic fermentation. This process, it takes place in the absence of oxygen. Third one, batch fermentation. It's closed culture system. So here you can see the pic of the fermenter. It's also called as bioreactor. So within this fermenter, the nutrient media is added through the inlet into the fermenter. And this media is sterilized, and to this the inoculum is also added. Later on it undergoes a process of incubation. Suitable pH has to be maintained either by addition of the acid or the base. Suitable temperature has to be maintained, and in the beginning aeration is required, so the sterilized air is let into the fermenter, into the fermenter. And here in the center you will find the impeller, which is connected to the motor, and this impeller, with help of the rotor, it brings about the proper mixing of the nutrient media with the inoculum. So this batch fermentation is an example of a closed culture system. Here a sterilized medium is inoculated and it is then incubated. Oxygen in the form of air, in addition to oxygen, anti-foaming agent, for example edible oils, then acids or bases to control the pH will be added into the fermenter. During incubation, what happens is the cells of the microorganisms, they will grow, that is they will multiply, and they will pass through the different phases of their growth, that is it undergoes metabolism. Now this process of fermentation is run for a definite period. Later on the culture broth is harvested, the product is then separated and it is purified for subsequent use. Now this process is used to produce biomass. It is also used in the production of primary metabolites as well as secondary metabolites. The fourth process is continuous fermentation. So as the name itself indicates, this process takes place continuously. So in the peak you can see this is the fermenter. This is the reservoir which is containing the nutrient media. And this nutrient media is let inside the fermenter either periodically, that is intermittently, or continuously. And how much ever medium is added, after a period of incubation, an equivalent amount of the medium will then be harvested. So at one end you have a nutrient reservoir, at the other end you have the harvester. Now let us look into this process in detail. So continuous fermentation is an example of a closed system and it is run for indefinite period. So fresh nutrient medium is added continuously or intermittently, and an equivalent amount of the used media with the microorganisms will be withdrawn either continuously or intermittently. This is done for the recovery of the cells or the fermentation products. The fifth type of fermentation is fed batch fermentation. Here the substrate is added periodically. Now this method is used for a production of baker's yeast, also for production of antibiotics like penicillin, thiostreptone by using Streptomyces laurentiae, then industrial enzymes, histidine, glutathione from Brevibacterium, phloem, lysine by using Cornibacterium glutamicum. Sixth type of fermentation is surface fermentation. So the microorganism grows on the substratum, and the substratum may be either solid or liquid. Now based on the physical state of the substrate, there are two types. It may be submerged fermentation, or it may be solid state fermentation, also called as solid substrate fermentation. Now in submerged fermentation, the nutrient medium is liquid, so the microorganism will grow within the medium, that is submerged in the medium. For example, most of the industrial fermentations. Now in solid state fermentation, the microorganism, it grows on the moist or the solid materials. Now let us look into the actual process, the second topic, that is industrial production of ethanol. Now this can be brought about by chemical method from ethylene, or it can be brought about by biological method, that is by the process of fermentation using the microbes. Now during fermentation, what happens is the sugars such as glucose, fructose, sucrose, etc., they are converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide. Now these are the chemical reactions that take place during fermentation. So this is a sugar, C6H12O6. To this, when yeast is added, the inoculum yeast is added, then the anaerobic fermentation takes place, and what happens is ethanol is produced, that is CH3CH2OH. Along with that, even carbon dioxide is produced, that is CO2, and along with this 28.7 kilocalories of heat or energy is also released. So let us look into this picture. Glucose is converted into pyruvate by utilizing the energy obtained from ADP. So ADP gets converted into AMP. Now this pyruvate gets converted into acetaldehyde by the process of decarboxylation. Now this acetaldehyde, then by utilizing the energy from NADH, which gets converted into NAD+, and in the process the energy is used for production of ethanol. Now let us look into the microorganisms that are used for industrial production of ethanol. So the bacteria used are Zymomonas mobilis, Clostridium, Acetobutylicum, Escherichia coli. The yeast used are Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Candida utilis, or even Cluveromyces fragilis. Now let us look into the further steps. What are the raw materials used for a production of ethanol? The raw materials may be either sugar, or it may be starchy materials, or even lignocellulosic materials are used. Now in sugars, either sugar cane can be used, that is sugar cane juice can be used, or cane sugar can be used, or even sugar beet is used. Among starchy materials, it may be corn, or it may be wheat, or it may be sweet sorghum, even cassava and yams may be used. Under lignocellulosic material, sugarcane bagasse can be used as raw material, or corn stover can be used, or even the cereal straws are used. Now let us look into pre-treatment of the raw materials. So when the raw materials are used, they have to be subjected to pre-treatment. Whenever sugary raw material is used, it may require mild pre-treatment, or it may not at all require any pre-treatment. In case of cellulosic materials, it requires pre-treatment, that is it is subjected to either acidic or enzymatic hydrolysis. Now let us look into the various steps for the production of ethanol. The first step is formulation of the medium. So if the medium used is molasses, then it has to be diluted with water, so that the sugar concentration will range between 10 to 18%. Whenever starchy materials are used, then it has to be hydrolyzed by dilute acids or by using fungi amylases. Second step is preparation of the inoculum, that is the mother culture or the starter culture. So suitable microorganism has to be identified to be used. It has to be selected. After selection, it has to be isolated, that is to get the pure culture. And when pure culture is obtained, then the mother culture or the starter culture has to be prepared on a pilot scale. So that is called as the process of preparation of the inoculum. So for this, the microorganisms, they are cultured in the flasks under aerobic conditions. The third step is the actual process of fermentation. So for production of ethanol, either batch fermentation procedure is used or continuous fermentation method is used. Now industrial production of alcohol is carried out in huge fermenters, which may range up to size of 125,000 gallons. The ideal pH maintained is 4.0 to 4.5. The initial temperature is kept between 21 to 26 degrees centigrade. Aeration is initially required for the good growth of the microorganisms, but later on anaerobic conditions are created, and this is done by withdrawing the oxygen coupled with the production of the carbon dioxide. Now it takes about 2 to 3 days for the process of fermentation to be completed. The broth finally contains 6 to 9% ethanol. The fourth step is the recovery of the ethanol. So the cell mass is separated by either centrifugation or sedimentation. The ethanol which is produced in the broth, it has to be recovered by process of successive distillations. For getting absolute alcohol, that is 100% ethanol, an azeotrophic mixture of benzene, water and alcohol is prepared, and then it is distilled. Now this is a flow chart wherein ethanol can be prepared from sugarcane. So sugarcane is taken, then it is subjected to extraction. So bagasse is obtained, and this bagasse again can be used for the preparation of ethanol, or it can be used for the preparation later on of the paper. Now from the sugarcane, on one hand, bagasse is obtained and sugarcane juice is obtained. Now this sugarcane juice can be directed into the fermenter, and a suitable inoculum can be added to obtain wine or to obtain ethanol. And this ethanol can be obtained by subjecting it to the successive distillation. Or the juice which is obtained from this, it is subjected to treatment, then later on it is evaporated to obtain the syrup. Now this syrup can be let inside the fermenter to obtain wine or to obtain the ethanol. Or from this syrup itself, it may be subjected to crystallization and drying to obtain the sugar. Now this is a pic which is showing the process of production of ethanol by using molasses. So you can see the container over here. This container has got the molasses. It is diluted with water and it is mixed to obtain the sludge. The sludge is then removed and it is further let inside the fermenter. This is also diluted with water. Then the inoculum, suitable inoculum, that is the yeast, is added to the fermenter. Then it is made to undergo a process of, it is made to incubate. After a period of incubation, then the broth will contain the ethanol. So what is done is steam is let into in order to bring about the process of distillation. So whatever ethanol is there, it gets evaporated. Then again, it is subjected to condensation so that the ethanol get condensed. Again, in the second step, the steam is let into. So in this way, a series of distillations are brought about. Distillations and condensations. Distillation is brought about by gradual rise in the temperature, and condensation by using the water. In this way, the pure alcohol or the ethanol is obtained. Now this is a pic which shows the ethanol production by using maize, that is corn. So when the corn is used, the grains or the cob is used, it has to be subjected to milling. Later on, it is subjected to saccharification, and then it is subjected to fermentation, and later on distillation is brought about and ethanol is obtained. Now apart from the maize grains or the cobs, the remaining plant biomass, that is called as the corn stover. Now this is also subjected to milling. Later on it has to undergo pre-treatment because it contains lot of lignocellulosic material. The further process is same as the grains when it is used. That is, it is subjected to saccharifications and further distillation to obtain the ethanol. Now let us summarize. Thus, fermentation is an enzyme catalyzed metabolic process where microorganisms, they convert starch or sugar to acids, gases or alcohol, and in the process energy is released. Industrial production of ethanol can be done by two methods, either by chemical method from ethylene or by biological method by fermentation using the microbes. Well, these are the references that I have used to prepare this particular presentation. Thank you.